Good morning, children. Children, as you know, we have started chapter number 6 and we were doing chemical properties of metals with some other reagents. And here I am talking about the other chemical properties in this video. Plus, I am recapitulating the last property which we have done, and that is reaction of different metals with different forms of water. Children, if you remember, sodium and potassium are highly reactive metals situated at the top of the reactivity series. They react violently with cold water and explosively with hot water. Sometimes during the reaction, due to the evolution of hydrogen, they used to catch fire. Calcium is less reactive than sodium and potassium. Calcium reaction is not that violent reaction. It is comparatively slow reaction, but calcium can react with cold water to form its hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Magnesium is less reactive than calcium. Magnesium only reacts with hot water to give magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Metals like aluminium, zinc, they only react with steam to form air oxides and hydrogen gas is liberated. In case of iron, we have to take iron as red hot iron, and on red hot iron, if we pass steam, we will get Fe3O4 and hydrogen gas. And the last, metals like copper, silver, gold, these are very, very less reactive metals situated at the bottom of the reactivity series, do not react with water at any temperature. Now, next. Next is reaction of different metals with acid. And particularly, children, we are talking about here dilute acids. Dilute acid, and we will talk here about hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid. Children, consider these four metals: magnesium, aluminium, zinc, and iron. Among these four, magnesium is the most reactive. Aluminium is less reactive than magnesium. Zinc is less reactive than aluminium, and iron is less reactive than zinc. I'm not talking about here sodium and potassium, because obviously we will know that these two metals will at all react acid or water at any temperature. Now, magnesium. If magnesium is treated with dilute hydrochloric acid, it will turn up into magnesium chloride and hydrogen gas is liberated. At the same time, children, if I am asking you what is the reaction with sulfuric acid of magnesium metal, it would be magnesium sulfate and hydrogen gas. Similarly, aluminium react with HCl to give you AlClIII and hydrogen gas. Zinc with HCl, it will give you zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. Iron will give you iron chloride. It could be ferrous, it could be ferric. Similarly, children, the vigor of this reaction is actually among these four metals is very fast in case of magnesium, comparatively slow in aluminium. Slower than aluminium, it will be in the case of zinc, and iron will also react slowly, but they will react to liberate hydrogen gas and make their respective salt. And these salt will remain in a form of salt solution. So children, on the basis of these four reactions, we can arrange these metals in the order which is given on the screen, that is, magnesium is the most reactive among these four, then aluminium, then zinc, and then iron. Children, copper and silver metals are less reactive metals situated at the bottom of the reactivity series. They do not react So copper, silver, gold do not react with hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid. Students, one more thing I want to add here. The metals like sodium, potassium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, they all are reacting metal to liberate hydrogen from acids, or reacting with water to liberate hydrogen from water. Why? Because these four metals, or all the metals which are reacting with acid to liberate hydrogen gas, or the metals which are reacting with water to liberate hydrogen gas, they used to give out their electrons rapidly than hydrogen. That is the only reason that they give out their electron, make their own salt, and hydrogen is unable to give out its electron and used to form hydrogen gas. In case of copper, silver, gold, they are less reactive than hydrogen. Hydrogen will give out its electron more rapidly than copper, silver and gold. That is why they will never liberate hydrogen gas if they are reacting with concentrated acids also. If at all they are reacting, they are giving us some products, but they will never give you hydrogen gas. Now let's talk about certain third oxidizing agent, that third mineral acid, that is nitric acid. And nitric acid is one of the strong oxidizing agent. Children, remember oxidizing agent. If somebody is oxidizing agent, that reagent will allow another reagent to get oxidized, and itself it will get reduced. Children, what happened in this case? When we are treating this nitric acid with these metals, what will happen? Hydrogen gas, which is forming, this hydrogen gas will combine oxygen, which is coming from nitric acid, and turn up into water. So instead of hydrogen gas, we used to get our water at the end product, plus nitric acid self-reduced into nitrogen oxides. It could be N2O, it could be NO, it could be NO2. Children, I'm repeating this point. Nitric acid is strong oxidizing agent. It oxidizes hydrogen into water, and itself it used to get reduced into into nitrogen oxides. It could be N2O, it could be NO, it could be NO2. Depending on the strength of nitric acid we have taken in the reaction. And the last point, children, there are two metals, manganese and magnesium, Mn and Mg. If we are taking these two metals and we are treating these two metals with 1% nitric acid, 1% nitric acid means 1 ml nitric acid in 99 ml of distilled water. Very, very dilute solution of nitric acid. If we take Mg or Mn and treated these metals with 1% nitric acid, then their nitrates plus hydrogen gas used to be liberated. Now, next. Next, and next is reactivity series of metals. Children, this series you already know, where metals are arranged in the decreasing order of their reactivity. metals arranged above than hydrogen in series are more reactive than hydrogen, and metals below than hydrogen are less reactive than hydrogen. Children, this is the base of displacement reaction also. I told you in chapter number 1, the displacement reaction is based on the reactivity of metals located in the reactivity series. So let's start displacement reaction. Displacement reaction is, one metal is taken, it could be added in another metal salt solution and observe the change. For example, I have taken copper sulfate solution and I have taken two metals, one is magnesium and another is iron. Copper sulfate solution is blue in color. Copper sulfate, may copper is the metal and magnesium and iron is added in different test tube because magnesium and iron are more reactive metals than copper, so they will displace easily copper from copper sulfate solution and make its own solution. So this is displacement reaction, when more reactive metal will displace less reactive metal from its salt solution, make its own salt solution. Children, in this reaction, you people have to memorize the color of the solution formed. Color of the solution we have taken in the at the initial of the reaction. Now next. Next, aquarasia. Actually, aquarasia is a mixture of hydrochloric acid and nitric acid. One part of nitric acid when mixed with three part of hydrochloric acid, aquarasia is formed. It is a fuming liquid. Fuming means the liquid where continuously kind of gas used to come out. When you make aquarasia, because nitric acid is strong oxidizing agent, it continuously start decomposing by coming in contact of atmospheric gases, and continuously NO2 gas used to be evolved from the container. So the liquid is called fuming liquid. Aquarasia is highly corrosive liquid. Generally, metals like gold, platinum used to be dissolved in liquid. Next is anodizing process. Children, anodizing is the process where thick oxide layer of aluminium is formed over the surface of metal. Anodizing, actually, it is a electrolytic passivation process. Electrolytic passivation process, the term means that it will avoid the corrosion of the inner layers. This process used to increase the thickness of natural oxide layer. Children, earlier I told you already that aluminium is self-protecting metal. It used to form aluminium oxide layer over itself, which used to guard the inner layer of aluminium. By increasing the thickness of this layer, the metal is secured. This process is called anodizing because the part to be treated forms the anode electrode in electrolytic cell. And this, during electrolysis, sulfuric acid is taken and electrolysis process is done. The oxygen gas, which is evolved at anode, reacts with aluminium to make a thick protective layer over the metal surface. This process is also been done for giving the attractive finish. This is also been done to increase the resistance to corrosion and wear. Also provides the better adhesion for painting purposes. So children, This is for the today's video. If any doubt, please ask me. Thank you.